الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، مباركا عليه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى جل جلاله وعم نواله، والصلاة والسلام على السيد الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه نجوم الهدى قادة التقى. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فلأغوينهم أجمعين إلا عبادك منهم المخلصين، صدق الله العظيم. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. Respected elders and brothers, mothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a perfect deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a verse in the Quran about which a Jewish man came to Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He came to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and he said to him that, O Umar, Allah revealed one verse of the Quran. If it was revealed for us, we'd have made that day a day of Eid. کہ جس دن یہ آیت اتری اگر یہ ہمارے اندر اگر یہ ہماری تورات میں یہ آیت اترتی تو ہم اس دن کو عید کا دن مناتے. You would make that day a day of Eid, this one ayat. And Umar says, which ayat are you talking about? Which verse are you talking about? And the Jewish man says, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. He says, this verse of the Quran, یہ آیت قرآنی, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ, کہ آج میں نے آپ کے دین کو مکمل کر دیا. I have completed your deen. I have perfected your deen. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, اور میری نعمتوں کو میں نے آپ پہ برسا دی. I have given you all my ni'am. I have given you all my blessings. وَرَضِيْتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا, اور میں نے آپ کے لئے اسلام چنا ہے. میں نے آپ کے لئے دین اسلام چوز کیا ہے. I have chosen دین اسلام. I am happy with دین اسلام for you. So the Jewish man says, if this ayat was revealed for us, the Jews, we would have made this day the day of Eid. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala says, we do make it a day of Eid. I know when this ayat was revealed, which year, which day, I know where it was revealed to. This was revealed in the Hajjatul Wida' on the day of Arafah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, this is one of the final verses to be revealed in the Quran. When Allah says, now your job is done. I have done everything I'm supposed to do for you. All the principles of deen have been noted down. جو سارے اصول ہیں دین کے وہ سارے میں نے آپ کو بتا دیئے, اور جو بعد میں فروعی احکام ہوں گے, those small things will come later which won't exist then. For example, small example, Allah says, I have completed the deen. So the question is, today we have mobile phones. In those days, there were no mobile phones. So how do I know whether using a mobile phone or the internet is halal or haram? It's not in the Quran. Because mobile phones didn't exist then. The internet didn't exist then. Uska wujud tha hi nahi us waqt. To jab Allah ne kaha ki mere deen ko mukammal kar diya, to uska maana kya hua jab aaj humne internet ko le liya? What does it mean? Allah is saying all the usools, all the principles of deen. کہ یہ حلال ہے یہ حرام ہے. So now look at internet. Look at the principles and look at internet. Does internet fall under that category? If it falls under the halal category, then it's halal. If it falls under the haram category, it's haram. On the internet, you can do good things and bad things. So the good things are halal and the bad things are haram. So they've given us the principles and we've just, anything new that comes, we just look at it and we say, ah look, this is haram like it says there, so I'll also make this haram now. For example, drugs. Things like heroin didn't exist then. Okay, they did exist, but didn't used to take it as drugs. Laughing gas. For example, laughing gas today didn't exist then. Laughing gas didn't exist then. So is it halal or haram? It's not in the Quran, it's not in the hadith. But the hadith says, anything which makes you lose your mind is haram. This makes you lose your mind is haram. So Islam taught us the principles. And any little thing that comes after will fall under one of these principles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us how to do a'mal. Allah ne hume ye bhi bataya. Allah ne sirf ye nahi bataya ki paanch namaz parni hai aapko. Allah ne bataya paanch namaz parni hai aur usko is tarah parni hai. That you have to pray five namaz a day. And this is how you pray. And not just how to pray physically. Not just sajda, qiyam, फिर रुकू फिर सजदा फिर तशहुद में बैठना. Allah also showed us that. He showed us you stand up, you bow, you prostrate, you sit. He showed us all that. Allah also showed us the spiritual side of worship. He taught us that you worship Allah physically and you worship Allah spiritually. What is the spirit of salah? Let me tell you something. For any deed, किसी अमल की कबूलियत और मकबूलियत के लिए दो शर्त है. For any deed to be accepted in the eyes of Allah, there are only two conditions. Not a million, just two conditions. If we fulfill these two conditions, inshallah, this deed will be accepted by Allah. Two conditions. Listen very carefully. The first condition is the deed we do must be physically perfect. What does that mean? It means I can't pray 4 rakats of Zuhr with 5 rakats. I might think today I want to become extra Sufi. Aaj mujhe zyada namaz parni hai. So instead of 4 rakats, I pray 5. Is it correct? No. Allah won't accept it. So firstly, the physical deed has to be good. Example in Song. From when do we fast? We fast from dawn till dusk. From Tulu' al-Fajr, from the start of Fajr time, the end of the night, until sunset. Now somebody says, I want to be Sufi today. And if it's a winter fast, that's very short, isn't it? It's maybe 6 o'clock to 4 o'clock, 7 o'clock to 4 o'clock. Because this is too short for me. Too short for me. I want to keep a longer fast. So I won't keep 7 o'clock to 4 o'clock. I'll keep the opposite. I'll keep a fast in the night and I'll eat in the day. I'll keep a fast in the night and I'll eat in the day. So he's done the complete opposite. Ikhlas to hai. He's sincere. But it's in what he's doing is wrong. Islam says do it this way. And he thinks he wants to do it according to his brain. So he says no, I'll do it a different way. Allah won't accept it. The second condition is ikhlas. So the physical form of the ibadah has to be perfect. And the spiritual form has to be perfect. Spiritual form is ikhlas. Who am I doing this deed for? And the physical form is doing it how Allah showed me to. Doing it how Rasulullah ﷺ showed me to. So this person who prayed 6 rakats of Zuhr instead of 4, did he have a bad intention? No. His intention was good. He said, I want to pray more rakats. I want more sawab. I want more sawab. The intention is right, but he prayed too many rakats, so it's invalid. And you got another person. He says, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prayed 4 rakats of Zuhr. So I'd also pray 4 rakats of Zuhr. But Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prayed in such a way when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to say, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam kehte sahaba ko, ke meri namaz mein itna mera zehn hota hai, zehn hazir hota hai, ke mujhe ye gumaan hota hai ke mere saamne jannat lai gayi. Aur mere saamne jahannam lai gayi. Aur main jannat ko dekh raha hoon, main jahannam ko dekh raha hoon. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's condition of salah was such that he says, I feel in my salah like Jannat has been brought in front of me, like Jahannam has been brought in front of me. I feel like if I were to stretch forward and take a bunch of Jannat, I could take the fruit from Jannat. And when I see Jahannam, I take a few steps back because I get scared and I start crying in my salah. So I might pray 4 rakats of Zuhr, but my spiritual state isn't perfect. Again, Allah doesn't have to accept. So what are the two conditions? The physical form has to be perfect. Do it how Allah showed you. Do it how Allah told you. Do it how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed you. Jis tarah Allah ne bataya karna hai. Jis tarah Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne bataya karna hai. Aur ikhlas ke sath karna hai. Ki mujhe ye amal sirf Allah ke liye karna hai, kisi aur ke liye karna nahi hai. If we have these two things in our worship, Allah will accept our ibadat inshaAllah. These two things, physically perfect, spiritually perfect. I'll tell you a benefit of ikhlas. The benefit of ikhlas is jab Allah ki hame zarurat parti hai. Rozana hame Allah ki zarurat parti hai. We need Allah every day. But sometimes you need Allah more than you need Him before. When you are in a difficulty, when you are in a very, very difficult position, then you think, I'm useless. Not a law, a lawyer is going to help me. A doctor isn't going to help me. Nobody from the dunya can help me. My parents and my friends can go away. Nobody can help me except Allah. Most of our problems, we'll ask Allah to help it, and Allah will make somebody else the means. We'll make dua to Allah. Allah will say, put it in our minds, go to a doctor, go to a lawyer, go to your parents, go to your friends, they'll help. Lekin basawqat aisa hota hai ki koi hame kaam nahi deta. Sirf Allah hume kaam dega. Nobody can help us except Allah. I'll give you a story. In the Sahih of Imam Bukhari, he writes that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yun farmaya ki Banu Israel ke teen aadmi chal pare. Three men from Banu Israel, you've heard this story many times, but I want to give you a moral from this story. The problem with us is, honestly, we listen to all these stories, qissa sunne ke baad wah wah kar dete hain, subhanallah subhanallah keh dete hain, fir jo qissa mein jo hame lena hai, jo hikmat hame leni hai qisse se, wo gum ho jati hai. The moral and the wisdom we have to take from the hadith and from the story is lost inside us. We listen to the story, mashallah, great story, great lecture, great bayan, I'm happy, woke up prompt by asr is forgotten, I don't even come to the masjid for asr. Okay? So, he says, three men from Banu Israel left their home. And a storm came, Barishui. And they enter a cave. They enter a cave. They stand inside the cave, and a huge rock and a huge boulder comes to cover the face of the cave. Ek bara chatan aaya, and it came and it covered the face of the cave. Ye teen aadmi andar baithe hue hain. Wo dekh rahe hain bahar ki kya ho raha hai. They see they've been covered in. They look outside, they see, we've been, what do we do now? They go to the rock, they try to push it, nothing happens. It's a rock, you can't move a rock that's covering the whole face, huge rock. Kya kare? They look at each other and they say, you know what? Ab to koi hamari madad nahi kar sakta. Nobody can help us today. Na koi bahir se aa sakta hai, na koi andar se hamari madad kar sakta hai. Sirf Allah ko hume bulana padega. There's only one way now. But this is what I mean. Rozana hume Allah ki zarurat hoti hai. But this is extra zarurat. This is an extra need for Allah. They say, what do we do? And they look at each other and they say, I've got an idea. Teen aadmi hai hum. Ek dusre ko dekhne lage aur kehne lage ki apni zindagi mein ek amal to aisa hoga, ek amal to hoga aisa ki jisko humne khalis Allah ke liye kiya hai humne. That there must be one action in our entire lives till today which we can look back on and we can say, Allah, I did this only for you. Allah, I did this only for you. So let's mention that deed, one of the three of us. So there'll be three deeds altogether, one from each person. Let's mention these deeds and let's tell Allah, Allah, I promise I did this only for you, and you can be my witness because you know the state of my heart. You can be my witness that this was only for you. Allah, if it was only for you, accept the deed and alleviate this problem from us. So the first man stands up and the first man makes dua. And the first man makes dua. The order might be slightly different, but the three amal are like this. The first one makes dua and he says that, oh Allah, I had parents. I had very old parents. And I had a very poor family. I had wife and I had children. And I had old parents. And when I bring food home, or when I brought milk home for them to drink, my family, my children and my wife would cry. And they would say, we have been hungry, we have nothing to eat today. Give us something to drink, give us something to eat. And my parents would be lying on the bed. But wallah, wallah, you know that I never ever used to give it to my family before I gave it to my parents. My first priority was doing a khidmah and servicing my parents, and then I'd be a servant for my family. Allah, one day, ek din aisa hua Allah, ke main ghar pahuncha, aur walidain soye hue the. My parents were sleeping. And I thought, kya kare? Dusre kamre se rone ki awaaz aa rahi hai. From the other room, I can hear them crying. Biwi ro rahi hai, bachche ro rahe hai. The wife is crying, the children are crying. Kya hum bhookhe hai? Khane ko nahi mila aaj. Kya kare hum? Lekin mera ek qanoon tha. کہ جب تک میں اپنے والدین کو نہ پلاؤں اس وقت تک کو میں اس میں ان کو نہیں دوں گا. So Allah, that whole night my parents were sleeping, I stayed by their bedside and I waited for them to wake up. I stayed by their bedside. I didn't give it to my family, to my wife and to my children. I gave it to my parents and I stayed up the whole night. Allah, they woke up in the morning and I gave the milk to them. And my children and my wife were still crying, Ya Allah, out of hunger. And I chose my parents over them. Allah, if I did this only for you, Allah, take this problem away from us. This story has many, many, many morals. Obey your parents. Be dutiful to your parents. Have ikhlas, have sincerity in everything you do. Allah will help you when you need Him the most. How much will we keep showing the world what we do? I received a message yesterday. Seriously, it's nothing to cry about. A friend of mine is an imam. I won't say where he's an imam. He's an imam in a masjid somewhere. And they also have a school. One person who wanted to donate said, I'm prepared to give $1 million to your school. How many? They need about 500,000-600,000. He said, I'll give you as much as you need and I'll give you more. I promise I'll give you $1 million. This is just yesterday. I'll give you $1 million. All your problems will go. So obviously he said, there must be a shirt. There must be something in the small print. Shirt kya hai uska? He goes, I am like a Juma hai. Thursday, today, tomorrow. I'm talking, seriously, this happened yesterday. He said, tomorrow is Friday. You have to stand up on the minbar and make an elan and say, this person donated this much money. You have to stand up on the minbar and you have to say that this person, Brother A, donated £1 million towards the school. £1 million towards the school. And he goes, not just that, make an elan about my name. Number two, name the school after me. Change the name of the school so it's my name. And put a plaque at the front of the school to say, this school has been donated by Brother A. You know what my friend said to him? My friend said, Hame aapke paise ki zarurat nahi. He said, we don't need your money. This school has been made to please Allah. I'm not going to destroy all the hard work just so you can have your name on a plaque. If you want to give it, your name won't be pulled out. This is happening yesterday. Yesterday. I'll forward the messages on to you if you want. This happened yesterday. This is the condition of us today. I want every single person to be happy. If Allah isn't happy, it doesn't make a difference to me. So the first person in the cave, three people in the cave, remember the rock came over the cave, front, the mouth of the cave? The first person says, Allah, I looked after my parents with ikhlas and sincerity. Allah took the problem away slightly. The second person stood up and the second person said, Allah, I hired a worker one day and he worked for me one day and I owed him, for example, I owed him £100 for the day's work. He went off and he never came back, Allah. He never came back. So I thought, I can't keep the money because it's his heart, blood, sweat and tears went into the money. So I said, Allah, I keep it for him. I invested this money for him, Allah. £100 became £1,000. £100 became £1,000. He came to me after many, many, many years. And he said, remember that day I worked for you? Can I have my money for that day? It was £100. Can I have the £100? And I gave him all £1,000. I gave him the full £1,000 to him. Even though I only owed him £100. But I invested the money and I gave him £1,000. And he said to me, he looked at me and he said, it was only £100. You gave me £1,000. And I said, brother, I invested this money for you. This is £1,000 I invested for you. Allah, if I did this only to please you, Allah, remove the rock from the mouth of this cave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again moved the rocks slightly. They weren't completely out yet. Then a third person stands up, and the third person, I believe he stands up and he says, Allah, I had a cousin who was very beautiful, and I fell in love with my cousin. And she was very poor and I was very rich. It made sense. I told her, I'll give you money, you let me fulfill your desires with you. And she was saying, no, no, no. And I said, please, you need money and I need to fulfill my desires. Give and take. Take the money. She said, no, no, no. One day, she was in a really bad situation. So she came to me and she said,
I have no choice now, I need the money. I said, you need money? One condition, let me fulfill my desires with you. And she said, find you what you wish, I need the money. So he says, Allah, we were alone in secret, nobody knew where we were. Allah was just about to start doing haram, and she said one word. She said two words to me, one sentence she said to me, ittaqillah. That's it. She said, ittaqillah. Fear Allah. Nothing else. She just said, fear Allah. Don't deflower me. Fear Allah. Allah, these words resonated and these words ran through my veins and it pumped in my blood. And I came off. And I went away and I told her, keep the money, I won't be committing haram today. Allah, if I stayed away from haram on that day, just to please you, Allah, remove this danger and remove this boulder from the mouth of the cave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remove the boulder from the mouth of the cave. And the people were revealed, and the people were relieved of their difficulty, and this problem was alleviated from them. This is the benefit of ikhlas. When you need Allah the most, Allah will come to help you. I promise Allah will come to help you. When you need Allah the most, He will come to help you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept all the good we do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help us to stay away from all evil things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help us perfect our actions, both physically, the physical form like I mentioned, and the spiritual form of our actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept our sitting and forgive all our shortcomings. Ameen wa akhir da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.